I want to share with you why you should be doing online appeals and how to do them correctly. Hi, I'm Bree Sokolowski, the founder of CatholicFundraiser.net, a website that's dedicated to helping Catholics just like you who have a mission, cause, nonprofit, and want to do more with their fundraising. CatholicFundraiser.net is visited by over 3,000 Catholics every month, and they keep coming back because they like the content, because one, it works. I've been doing this for several years. And then two, it's faith-based. It speaks directly to your faith and it connects really well with your mission. So I highly recommend that if you haven't done so already, jump over to CatholicFundraiser.net and download a free guide, a free fundraising guide called The 10 Commandments to Catholic Fundraising. This is 10 things that I think you should be doing with your fundraising, because it's 10 things that I found have been very successful for me and Catholic organizations across the board, whether you're a school, a religious order, a lay apostolate, a parish, a diocese, a hermit. I've had kind of a cloistered monastic community use them as well, and they really like it. So download that and get fundraising moving forward. Okay, today I want to talk about online donations. And if you see me or hear me pause, it's because I'm reading my article. Jump over to CatholicFundraiser.net/articles. There's also a link in these show notes. And I just want to talk to you about why you should be considering a different approach, and that's the online approach to your Catholic fundraising. And two reasons specifically. Well, one, we've seen a dramatic shift in how we fundraise. For a long time, it was very based by direct mail, and you had to just, you know, print a whole lot of letters, pack them in envelopes, and mail them, otherwise known as cost. You gotta get the stamps, you gotta get the envelopes, you gotta get the paper, you gotta do the printing, you gotta get the folding and putting everything in, and you gotta send it. But now, you can pretty much send 2,000 emails for the same cost as it would cost you one letter. One letter, 2,000 emails. And we know that the old adage is true. You ask and you will receive. And if you ask a whole lot, you're going to receive a whole lot more. So if you can ask a whole lot more with the same amount of price, so for one letter, you can send 2,000 emails. Well, those 2,000 emails are going to get you probably more donations. And also, in respect to donations online, so just people visiting your website, you know, it's much easier to get 2,000 people to visit your website. You add social media, you just add Google, a whole bunch of different things, and I'm gonna get into how you actually do it, but just, we have to understand the base of sending letters is the old-fashioned way. There are certain times to do it, yes. I'm not saying throw it out completely, but if you have a small budget, I highly recommend you go the online route. And so right now I'm gonna talk to you about three different things that I think you should be doing with online donations and online appeals. So the first thing that I want you to do is I want you to publish content on a regular basis on your website. So websites have kind of seen a shift in their use over the years. Before, it was just very static. You just built an about page, a mission page, a who are you page, who's your board. All this stuff is static, and that's what people don't really relate to anymore. People relate to updates, what you're doing. So instead of just saying what your mission is, you've got to be publishing content on a regular basis on what your mission is doing. If you have volunteers or you have staff and you have a staff page, you have to have content that explains what the staff is doing. So it's not just a matter of saying here, this is who we are. It's more along the lines of this is what we're doing. And you've got to be speaking to people directly. I had a really good point on my article. It was, people are searching for content that communicates with them, not at them. So that's number one. That's what I want you to do. Number two, The second thing that I want you to do is replace the donate button with prayer intentions, a prayer intentions button, or a prayer request button, or a light a candle button, or a helpful resource, or learn more about it. Something different. And you can kind of, you can kind of think of it like this, and this is how I think about it. When somebody walks into a parish or a cathedral or a chapel, the first thing that they don't get see or are confronted with is a please donate. Instead, it's trying that connection both physically and spiritually. So you probably have stained glass windows, you probably have some candles, you probably have some lighting in a specific way. If it's an adoration, you know, the lighting is set a specific way. So it's all to welcome people into the chapel or into the church or the cathedral. It's not immediately, hey, ask for a donation. And that's usually where a donate button is at the top right. It's at that prime spot. Well, you want to change it up and you want to say, well, what's the more spiritual and engaging thing that I can do? And that's what I want you to do, is replace the donate button with prayer intentions. I know it sounds a little flipped when we're talking about online fundraising, online appeals, online campaigns, remove that donate button. Well, it's because people, when they visit your website, for the most part, they're not looking to donate and they're usually new to your website. And then the third thing that I want you to do is I want to you to track your website, your web traffic. Track your web traffic. More than likely, and it's for a very few, you probably don't have a lot of traffic. And that's something that needs to change. You have to get people footpath. And you do that through your blog, and you also do that by not asking for a donation. If you can get their contact information and somehow develop a deeper relationship with them, and you develop content that they like, they're going to be coming back to your website. If you don't do that and it's very static and you're asking for a donation, more likely you're not getting a lot of traffic. And the reason you want to track your traffic is you want to make sure that the changes that you're doing actually are increasing that foot traffic to your website. So these are three different things that you can do. I also provide links on how to go further on once you get the traffic going, once you're blogging or developing some type of content, and you're also changing those buttons, things to talk about on how to actually get donations. If the donate button is not at the top, where do you put it? If you're blogging, how do you get people engaged? Because that's the real key, is once people see your blog, that's how you want to start engaging with them, through comments, through other links, etc., etc. But I'm going to pause right now. These videos are not meant to be long. If you're listening on the podcast, these podcasts are not designed to be long, but just to provide some type of drop knowledge bomb to help you with your fundraising. Okay, hope you liked it. Leave a comment, share it with a friend, and just keep moving with your fundraising. God love you, and I will see you next week.